You know, first of all, we have to realize that what is it that we do to the company and what is it that company does to us? I am feeling lonely. And I get someone to be with. What will I do with that person? Look at it. I will only use that person. I will use that person to fill up my loneliness. That fellow will become a tool for me, a usable for me, a thing for me. And then if some other person can fill up my loneliness better, then some other person would be better. Because what is the purpose? What is the reason why this person has come to my life? Why has this person come to my life? Because I was feeling lonely. So loneliness is important. The person is not really important. Do you get this? The person is just a means to some end. What is the end? Getting rid of loneliness. Now, will I give freedom to this person? I use this person. When I use something or somebody, can I give him freedom? I use this. Right? At this moment, if it wants to go and take a walk, will I allow it? Why will I not allow it? Because I am using it, I am dependent on it. When I am dependent on somebody, then the relationship can never have love. Because in dependence, in an environment of dependence, there can be no freedom. The more you depend, the more dangerous you become for the person you are dependent on. You know, it was in Goa, and there were these lifeguards. And one of them said, we save people, but even in saving people, we apply discretion. If there is somebody in such a desperate, bad and hopeless condition, that is, mind has totally gone out, then sometimes we decide not to save him at all. We let him sink. Or rather, we prefer to save somebody else. Now that was very strange. These are lifeguards and it is their duty, their work to save. Why are they not then saving? He said, the one who becomes desperate, the one whose mind becomes totally captive to fear, will cling to the lifeguard in such a way that even the lifeguard will drown. If a fellow is drowning and he has become very afraid, and you give your hand to him, and you give him a basic instruction, he will not listen to you. Fear makes the mind go mad. The fellow will drown and he will take down the lifeguard along with him because he has become totally dependent on the lifeguard. He is seeing that I am dying. So the moment he comes in contact with somebody, he takes the other fellow also down with him. This is what dependence does to you. Loneliness means dependence on somebody else. I have been saying this fundamental thing since long to you all. It is high time you understand this. If you really want to have healthy and loving relationships, kindly put the dependence factor out of the relationship. You cannot have a healthy relationship when the two people keep on missing each other in their loneliness, when the two people are dependent financially on each other, or one of them is dependent on somebody else, or when one is dependent for reasons of security, you know, one fellow is providing a basic security, then this is just a relationship of give and take. There cannot be any love in it. There would be fear in it, and there would be violence in it. So, instead of asking that I am lonely, what to do, see what happens when you get along with somebody for reasons of loneliness. Are you doing justice to that person? Are you really doing justice to that person? And if that person is with you, is it not just out of a sense of mercy? The fellow is maybe soft-hearted. But do you want to get somebody's mercy or do you want to have love? Yes, what do you want to have? Would you like it? I take pity on you. Somebody comes and says to you, you are pitiful, versus somebody says you are lovely. What would you prefer? Being pitiful or being lovely? To go to somebody because you are feeling lonely is to become pitiful. Do you want to be an object of pity? I have nobody in my life, please help me. You are my only savior, please help me. Without you, I will commit suicide, please help me. Do you really think this is healthy? So, pay attention to the relationship. When you will see that a relationship born out of loneliness only causes suffering to all the people involved, then automatically your ways will change. Realization is the biggest power. Once you really understand, then the right action happens on its own. Realization is the biggest power. Pay attention to your relationships. See what is at work. Alright? Then what is rotten will automatically stop and drop. Clear?